So first of all, I would like to introduce myself. So myself Ziaur Rahman Ansari, and I have done M.Tech in Structural Engineering, and I have work experience of almost all the sectors like government sector, private sector, in academics. And since last few years, I am working as an independent design consultant and software trainer. And for easy flow of this complete session, without of having any disturbance, you all have to follow some instructions. So during this demo session, don't ask any question. Whatever your doubts, whatever your question is there, just keep in mind. And at the end of the session, we will spend some time for the doubt clarification. What's your doubts, what's your queries is there, we will discuss on that. So please, it's request to all of you, don't ask any question in between of my discussion, in between of my explanation. Whatever your doubts is there, you can write in chat box. If I feel it is important to answer at that time, I will definitely try to answer. Okay. And in between, if I ask any question, you all have to write to give the answer. In between, I will ask some question. So you have to answer to that question if you are knowing about that. Okay. So without wasting time, we are just going to discuss all the things for the purpose we have here joined together. So if you want to become a professional structural engineer, and if you want to design any kind of structure on your own, so what important things you need to know? That's very important thing. Okay. So first of all, we are trying to understand why you should go with this training program. Why you have to register for this training program, and what is the need? What is the current need of these all things? So basic thing is that if you want to become a professional structural engineer, if you want to design any kind of structure, so there are some important points you need to know. And there are some important things you have to take, you have to get the commands over all those things. So if you want to work as a structural engineer, if you want to start your own consultancy, if you want to design any kind of structure, so what things is actually needed? So these are the four pillars that will make you a perfect structural engineer. And whenever you are going to work anywhere, they require this kind of skills in you, actually. So first of all, they will ask about how many softwares you are knowing, or how many softwares you are having the command, how efficiently you can work with different kinds of the softwares. So very first responsibility of yours, if you want to become a structural engineer, so you need to look into the market, which softwares are in demand. Which softwares is in demand? So if you look into the market, there are too many softwares. There are too many softwares. So you have to find which software is in demand. And with this software, you can complete your work. And how many softwares you need to learn for completing any kind of project. So in market, if you are looking, so too many softwares are there. If you see, so well-known software is what? ETAP software is there, StatPro software is there. Like that, too many softwares are there. So whenever you are going to face, if you are pursuing your master's, okay. So if you are going to face any interview, so interviewer will first ask about the question of how many softwares you are knowing. What you have done your bachelor's, master's, that's the second thing. That is the current scenario. They will ask about how many softwares you are knowing. Okay, if you are having the software knowledge, yeah, you are having the software like ETAP software you are knowing, and RCDC software you are knowing. Okay, so that will be good. Then you will come to the next question. It will ask about the different skills. They are trying to find different skills in you. So very first thing is what? You have to get the command over the softwares. You should be able to use the software. Software is what? Software is just a tool. If you are giving the right input, you will get the right output. If you are giving the wrong input, you will get the wrong output. So it's just a software, and you should able to understand what how to correct this software, how to get the correct result from this software. Okay, so this is a very important thing. What next important thing is interviewer will ask about you? They will ask about the basic concepts. Now they are going to check what you have done, how many what deep knowledge you are having. What are different grades of the concrete? What are the different grades of the steel? What will be the structure behavior under the different kinds of the loading? If your structure is subjected to gravitational loading, so how your structure is going to deform? If your structure is subjected to lateral loading, so how your structure is going to be deformed? What will be the bending moment diagram? What will be the shear force diagram? What are the different grades of the concretes? What are the different grades of the steel? What will happen if your structure is subjected to lateral loading like earthquake and wind loading and all other different types of the loading? So how deep knowledge you are having, the interviewer will check. So that's very important. If you want to become a structural engineer, so first thing you need to have the software command. You need to have the knowledge about the software, its the utilization. Thereafter, they will ask about your basic knowledge, your deep, how deep you are having, deep knowledge you are having. In respect of the structural behavior, in respect of the material study. So that's the second important thing you need to know. And then what third point will be there? Okay, you are having the knowledge about the design software, you are perfect in the basic concepts. Then what next thing is there? Design course knowledge. What is the use of this design course? Bureau of Indian Standard has suggested some guidelines. These design codes are what actually the guidelines. You have to follow these guidelines. If you are not following this guideline, so what will happen? You are going to make your structure is as uneconomical as well as the unstable. There is the possibility of the failure of your structure. So the design codes, its important clauses, its important limitations. What are the different codes are available? That you need to know. What are the different codes? There are so many different codes are there. IS 456 is there. IS 800-2007 is there for the steel structure. IS 18-93 is there for the earthquake loading. For 13920 for the ductile detailing. For the high-rise structure, 16700-2017. So these all are the different codes. So without of having the knowledge of these different codes, you are not able to design your structure as economical as well as stable. These are the guidelines. And what will happen if you are not following these guidelines? You are going to harm the building also and the people living inside of the building also. There is a possibility of life of a structure also. There is a possibility of life of the human beings which are living inside of the building also. Okay, so that's a very important thing. So this is the third important thing. What percentage, minimum percentage limit in your column? What maximum percentage limit of percentage limit in column, in beams? How to provide the reinforcement? Who will decide how to cut the bars? How to bend the bars? Where to provide the main reinforcement? Where to provide the shear reinforcement? What does mean by the main reinforcement? What does mean the shear reinforcement? Their limitation, who will define, who will decide, what should be the minimum, what should be the maximum limit of the deflection of the beam, maximum limit of the lateral deformation of the structure, how you check the stability of the structure, who will define? So design course knowledge is very important. If you are having the design software knowledge, if you are having the basic concepts, if you are not going to practice it with the codes, okay, so you are not going to make your structure as economical as well as stable. So this is the third point, is very important. And if you are collecting these all three points, okay, that's you will be a good structural engineer. But what fourth thing is what? Interviewer ask about what experience you are having. What does mean by the experience? It means that how many real life projects you have designed. How actually you have deal with the projects, different projects. Because see, every project will have the unique difficulties. There will be some difficulty with the substructure. There will be some difficulty with the superstructure. Got it? So difficulties will be there associated with all the different kinds of the structure. and tackling of that different situations and designing of the structure is nothing but the experience. So working with the software and getting the training with the software is not the meaning that you are going to just learn the commands of the software. What's your objective is what? You want to become a structural engineer. You want to design a structural engineer. So you need to learn all those things practically. You have to deal the real life projects. Medium rise structure, high rise structure. Okay, any kind of structure you should have you should have the experience over that. Okay, so by just keeping all these things in mind and in requirement, we have prepared this training program. And this training program will take you in the next level. Whatever the knowledge you are having, it will take you in the next level. Here we are going to cover all the things from basics to advanced in respect of your software knowledge, in respect of your design knowledge, in respect of your site knowledge, in respect of your coder knowledge. All the things we are going to cover here. So here we are going, the complete training we have divided into three sections. In the first section, what we are going to cover all the basic concept of the ETABS, basic commands of the ETABS. Some advanced commands also we are going to discuss. Then we are going to work with the validation of the software. Hello, am I audible to all of you?
Yes.
Okay. So in the first section, what we will discuss, basic commands, basic knowledge of the software. Then validation of the software is there. No one talking about this validation of the software. It means what? Whether you are getting the correct output or not. If you are giving the right output, you should get the correct output. So we are going to validate the software with the different structural elements. Then we will take some sample projects. Some sample and dummy project will be there. And see, in this we are going to cover all the commands of the software. All the commands of the software in very, very brief manner. Very detailed discussion will be there for the modeling of the column, for the modeling of the beam, for the modeling of the slab. Many things are there. So objective of the first section will be what? There we are going to make you familiar with the software first. Unless and until you are not having the knowledge of the software, how you can work with this? So first thing will be there. Now second thing will be what? There will be the G+T 4-5 building will be there. That is medium rise structure. And we are going to analyze and design this complete structure. Okay. From start to end. From architectural plan to till the releasing drawing for the site execution. Very brief discussion will be there. That we will talk about later after some time. So this will be the second section. Then in the second section also, we are going to cover the scheduling. Manually, how to read the design output of the ETABS software, then how to prepare the schedule manually, then we will go for the scheduling for the scheduling and detailing with the RCDC software, and then we are going to move, we are going to learn high rise structure and all the stability concern we are going to discuss in respect of all the advanced codes like IS 1893-2016, IS 13920 and IS 16700, all the IS1 concept we are going to cover there. So this is what is the total program, and in this what daily live sessions will be there in evening, and the same live session will be provided as a recorded video next day of the session. Daily doubt clarification will be there. One side conversation will not be there. Like a classroom based scenario will be there. Anytime you can ask any question, whatever you are having. Too many practice materials are there we will provide. And at the end of this training, we are providing the certificate also. So we will see all these things in detail. Okay, you all are with me? Hello? You all are with me?
Yes.
Okay. Now next, if you want to become, means if you want to design any project, okay, if you are beginner, if you are new in this field. Okay, so if you want to complete any project, you have to move through a steps, design steps. So what is the flow of completion of any project you need to know? So first thing is what? The detailed study of architectural drawing. So owner will come to the architect and the architect will prepare the plan. I'm not going to discuss in detail, okay, due to time constraint. Okay, so architecture will prepare the plan and that architecture plan will come to you as a structural engineer. So this kind of architecture plan will be there. This kind of real life project you have to deal. Then you are getting the confidence. Actually, what happening with the students, they are getting the training, but they are not getting the confidence. And how the confidence will build based on the real life project. When you are dealing the real life project, so real life problems you are going to face. And solving that real life problem, making you experienced person. Am I right or wrong? Hello?
Yes.
Okay, so this kind of architectural plan you are having, okay, so every architectural plan will be different. That's why I'm telling you, every project will have its unique difficulties. Got it? So, architectural plan. So, once you get the architectural plan, you have to read this architectural plan very carefully. So too many things you have to read here. What is the layout of this architecture plan? What is the position of your bedrooms, your WC and balconies, and what are their areas? Too many things are there. What is the width of the wall? So you have to learn this architecture plan very carefully. Unless and until you are not getting the knowledge of architectural drawing, you are not able to understand the architectural drawing, you will not be able to create your model. You will not be able to create your model correctly. And if your model is wrong, if you are not getting architecture plan correctly, you are going to model wrong, or you are going to create wrong model. If you are creating wrong model, then analysis will be wrong, then design will be wrong, then your output will be wrong. That's why very first step is what? You have to understand the architectural drawing. So what things is there you need to know over the architectural drawing? What things you have to study in architectural drawing that we are covering in the complete training program? In very brief. Okay, what next step is there after the completion of this after reading of this architectural drawing? You have to prepare the structural framing plan. You have to prepare the structural framing plan, or we can say beam layout. So what does mean by the beam layout? What includes the beam layout? So this is what actually the beam layout. If you look, this is what actually the beam layout. Okay, so this beam layout will include the positions of the column, positions of the beams, their labels, position of the sunk slab. So too many things are also there to learn about the structural framing plan. That's very important. So first thing over the architectural plan, what you need to do, you have to put the columns over the architectural plan. In respect of the column, three things are very important you need to decide at the preliminary stage. What should be the section size of the column? What should be the positions of the column? And what should be the orientation of the column? Try to understand. Can anyone repeat? Hello? Positions of the column. And second one is what? Orientation of the column. And third, preliminary section size of the column. Hello. Am I audible or not?
Yes.
So these three important points, sir, you have to take the decision over these three important points. So lot of things are there to discuss this. How you can decide the preliminary section size of the column? So there are some guidelines. There are some thumb rules based on the experience are there. Over that, you can decide the preliminary section size of the column. Actually, the economy of your structure are mainly depends on the column position, column size, and column orientation. It is little bit deep. Okay, when you are discussing in detail with me, I will explain how your structure economy is mainly depends on the column position, column orientation, and column preliminary section size. If you are going to provide one extra column from base to top of the structure, so it is going to create unnecessary extra cost to your structure. We have a proof for that. Okay, so you have to decide the preliminary section size. So there are some guidelines, some rules are there. We are discussing this all in detail. So based on that, you can decide. And if, along with that, okay, some spreadsheets are there. Using this spreadsheet, you can decide the how what the preliminary section size of the column is required. If you are going to fix 230 width, so what depth is required? So it will suggest. This sheet will suggest all these things. Okay, so just for example, 5 floors are there and detailed discussion is there. Okay, so width, if suppose I am going to provide 230, so depth is required 500 almost or 550. So this is what preliminary section size. So thumb rule is also there and some sample calculation is also there. Based on that, you can decide the preliminary section size of the element. Then you have to decide the positions of the column. Then you have to decide the orientation of the column. Orientation of the column is very, very important thing. Okay. Then also you have to decide the preliminary section size of the beam. Then you have to decide the preliminary section size of the slab. And after making all this decision and all this consideration, you have to prepare the beam layout. Once you complete this beam layout, what next thing is there? What your work is going to be start with the software. Your work is going to be start with the software. So you need to come to the software first. You need to come to the software. So when you come to the software, what you have to define some basic things. So if you are going to work, okay, your work is now completed with the CAD and your work is going to be start with the ETAP software. So as I told you, you should have a knowledge how efficiently you can use this software. How to handle this software? Okay, how to handle this software? What things you have to do first? What things you have to do next? So once you get into the software, what you have to define some basic things like material properties, section properties, and how to define them, and what important things are there. Okay, so too many things are there to discuss. That we are covering in this training program. So once you are having this, So what first thing you have to define some basic things. Then you have to prepare the grid lines. You have to prepare what? You have to prepare the grid lines. So what is the purpose of preparing the grid lines? So grid lines is what? Just a guideline. That's a reference line, not guideline. Sorry, it's a reference line. That will help to create your model. That you will help to prepare your model. Without having this some reference line, you are not able to correct your model. Okay, so how to create the grid lines? How to create the grid lines? So there are three methods of creating the grid lines. Offset point method is there, and it has quick template option is there. Export import method is there. So if suppose this kind of simple geometry of the building is there, simple geometry, so it is okay. You can proceed with this simple preparing the grid lines, normal grid line. Okay, if the architectural geometry is simple, so what? You can directly prepare this grid line. You can prepare these grid lines. Okay, this is only the grid lines. So you can directly prepare these grid lines in the software. But let's see, it is complicated geometry. So if you are going to prepare the grid lines for this kind of structure, you will not able to prepare the grid lines. You can prepare, but that will be very difficult. That will be a tedious job, time consuming job. So in that situation, what we'll do, we are going to export the drawing from CAD, center line from the CAD, and we are going to import that in ETAP software directly. So how to do these all things we are covering in this training. Okay, after having these grid lines, you have to model the columns. Let's see, you have to model the columns. So how to model this column? How to orient this column? how to make available this column in the window, how to off this from off the window. We are talking about in respect of modeling. So in this training, we are covering these all things in a very detail in first section. We are making you familiar at the advanced level with the software first. Then we are going to learn how to model the beams, how you can model the curved beam, how you can model the inclined beams, how you can model the zigzag beams. So, okay, every type of the beam we are going to learn. How to model your beam for a fixed length, for the short length, for the long length. So lot of things are there. Here we have to discuss in respect of modeling of the structural elements. Some important concept we are also trying to learn, like how to what does mean by the shell element. If you are going to design model the slab, okay, if you are going to define the slab, so how to model the shell element, how to model the membrane element, what are their means structural behavior difference of the membrane of the shell element, membrane element. So these all things are there, you need to understand, and we are covering in brief, in detail. So after having this, we are going to model the slab. So modeling of the slab you have to do. Then shear wall, how to model, that we are also covering. So overall we are going to complete our model. Then the next point is what you have to assign the load. So what are the important codes? What are the important codes are there? In a brief discussion will be there about that. Like IS 875 part 1 is there for the detail, for the defining the dead load of the material, dead weight of the material, density of the material. IS 875 part 2 is there for the live load. IS 875 part 3 for the wind load. So different kinds of the loads are there. Once you have completed your modeling, you need to go for the assigning of the load. So you have to assign the load over all the beams. You have to assign the load over all the slabs. How you can calculate? How you can calculate the floor finish load over the slab? How you can calculate the load? How you come to know about how much load you have to assign over the slab as a live load? For the different kinds of the building, like it is a residential building, commercial building, industrial building. So IS 875 part 2 is there for the defining of live load. IS 875 part 1 is for the defining of density of different materials. Got it? So overall, we have to complete the assigning of the load, and you can see your loading. You can see the loading. How you can see the loading? Just go to display load to assign frame load. Okay, live load is there like this. Let's see how to see. Go to display, go to load assigns, frame load under the SIDO load pattern. What does mean by the SIDO load pattern? What does mean by the live load? What is the dead load? So brief discussion will be there about this also. So complicated geometry of building we are going to learn here. What other training centers they do? They are taking simple dummy project and they are giving the training on just modeling of the things and showing that the sections are passing. That's all. So that's not the means way of learning as per my view. Real life project you need to deal. Real life content you have to discuss. So here we are going to cover all those things. Real life project we are going to deal. Real life exercise we are going to do. Okay. So after having the loading, what next step will be there? What you have to proceed for the analysis. You have to proceed for the analysis. So when you are going to proceed for, okay, in loading, what kind of loads will be there? Dead load will be there. Live load will be there. Earthquake loading will be there. Wind loading will be there. Then what are the different methods of analysis if you are going to assign the earthquake loading? So static method is there. Let me show you. Okay. So in this, what a basic concept will be there, like how your structure is deformed under the gravitational loading. Gravitational loading will include what? Your dead load, live load, superimposed dead load. Okay. So that is the basic. What advanced topics will be there? Here we are going to cover like earthquake loading. That's very important if you are going to deal high-rise structure more than 20 floor, 30 floor. Okay, so earthquake loading, it's a calculation, it's the method of analysis. What are the different methods of analysis? So a static method is there, dynamic method is there. Then there will be the linear and non-linear will also be there. So here we are going to cover all the advanced topic also. In advanced topic, what we are going to cover? Earthquake loading, it's a calculation, method of analysis, stiffness, ductility and strength concept. No one talking about this. Then wind loading calculation, it's a method of analysis. So we are having the spreadsheets, we are having very excellent spreadsheet that will give you all kinds of the loadings. See, if you want to calculate the wall load, if you want to calculate the wall load over the height of the structure at different floors, so you can use this spreadsheet. If you want to calculate the area load, you can use this spreadsheet. If you want to calculate the seismic loading, you can use this spreadsheet. If you want to calculate the wind loading, software can calculate the wind load on its own. But what experts recommend that if you are going to deal high-rise structure, so don't trust on the software completely. So some things we are going to do manually for our satisfaction. So for that we are having this kind of excellent sheets that will give you what lateral load is coming at different floors of the structure. So these Excel sheets we are sharing with you. All the practice materials we are taking in this training, we are sharing with you. Got it? Now next will be what? So what advanced topic will be there? Then modal analysis. What does mean by the modal analysis? Okay, for the checking of the stability of the structure, whether your structure is torsionally irregular or regular. So what software you are going to see? What analysis you have to follow? Modal analysis. See, what your IS 1893-2016 says that your building should not have the torsion. Your building should not have the torsion in the first mode and second mode. Your first mode and second mode should be free from torsion. So what does mean the modal analysis? So by the modal analysis, with the modal analysis, we are going to look at the behavior of the structure under the application of the lateral loading. How the structure is going to deform. So that is nothing but the modal analysis, and too many things are there in respect of the modal analysis. Okay, so see, suppose. Okay, yes. Now next P delta analysis. What the purpose of P delta analysis? Why we are going to perform the P delta analysis? Then concept of meshing of different structural element. So these all things are needed to perform in your structure before of analysis. If you are going to deal high rise structure, if you are going to deal means the structure which is subjected to lateral loading like wind load and earthquake load. What is the concept of the meshing? What is the importance of the concept of meshing? What are the different load combinations for the different kinds of structure? Orthogonal building, non-orthogonal building. Which building is orthogonal building? Which building is non-orthogonal building? So the code has defined different load combinations. So if you are going to deal high-rise structure and the structure is subjected to earthquake loading and wind loading, so about 75 load combination you have to define. About 75 load combination you have to define. So what does mean by the load combination? Can anyone tell me what does mean by the load combination? Hello? What does mean by the load combination? In general, I'm asking to all of you. Anyone, please. In general, I'm asking about the load combination. What does mean by the load combination? Tell me fast.
It's more than one load acting on the particular structure.
Okay, partly. Anyone else?
There may be a live load and dead load. Live load, dead load and wind load. And live load, dead load, wind load and earthquake load.
Yes, okay. But I am asking about in general, what does mean by the load combination? Define me what is the load combination. Hello. Define me simple load combination. So it is what actually load combination means what? Actually, the possibility of different kinds of the loads to which your structure is subjected. The possibility of combination of different loads to which your structure will be subjected, that is nothing but the load combination. So your structure may be, a dead load to your structure will be subjected every time. Your structure will have this dead load every time or not. There will be the possibility of acting of the earthquake load sometime. Earthquake load will not be for the long life of the structure. Your structure will not be subjected to long life with its wind load. That will be the short period. That will be the sometime. Live load will also be not, your structure will not be subjected to always live load. It will be possible that your building will be empty. Kavita, hello.
Yes.
Kavita, am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, is it possible or not? Your building will be vacant. Your building will not be not having any people inside of the building. Okay, so your structure, what are the different loads or combination of the loads to which your structure will be subjected? That is nothing but the load combination. So too many things are also there to discuss about the load combination. Okay, I am not going to discuss those all things in detail right now. Okay, so that will be included here, and that very important to discuss. Okay, that is an important point of discussion. Then overhead water tank loading load calculation. So we have explained sheet, Excel sheet. See how to calculate the overhead tank load, how to calculate this overhead tank load. So that we'll also discuss. Some part of discussion will be there in respect of the calculation of the load. Then what other points will be there? Yes, modeling of the retaining wall, structural stability according to IS 1893 139 20 16700. One point I have taken just now, that is modal analysis, requirement of the torsion irregularity. So too many things are there. At just for the example, I have taken one point. So structural stability is very important. So these all are the advanced concept you are going to take. So if you are going to work in any metropolitan cities like Bombay, Pune, okay, so there they are designing the structure more than a 15 floors, 20 floors. So there you have to work with all these things. What is the important concept, important point of stiffness, ductility and strength? That is very interesting topic. This is my favorite topic. Okay, so what is the use of this, and what is the what its concept? Okay, so that is these all things we are covering in our training. So after application of the loading, you are going to analyze your structure. We are going to analyze your structure, just perform the analysis. So after the modeling, you have to check your model. See, for every step, you have to define something before of the step. Suppose I'm talking about the modeling. So before of the modeling, some settings will be there. Then you have to perform the modeling. Then after the step, check will be there. After the step, check will be there whether you have done the thing right or wrong. That's very important. No one will tell you about this. So before of step, settings will be there, and after the step, checks will be there. So once you completed your modeling, you have to check your model whether there is a warning message is there or not. Is there any warning message in your model? If you see, I told you, if the model is wrong, your analysis and later stages will be wrong. That's why you have to focus with the modeling first. Is it right or wrong? If error is there, you have to correct that. So you should have a knowledge with the software how to correct your model if the warning and messages are there. Warnings and errors are there. That we are also covering in very detail. Then after having all these things, we are going to perform the analysis. So before of analysis, some settings will be there, like defining of the loads, load patterns, assigning of the loads, load combination. Too many things are there. Just some parts I have covered just now. Now then perform the analysis. So we are going to perform the analysis. After the completion of the analysis, the deformed shape of structure we are having. This is what deformed shape of structure. Under the application of the loading, how your structure is going to deform. So as I told you, after the completion of the step, checks will be there. So you have to check whether your analysis is done correctly or not. Is there any problem in your analysis? Problem with the analysis means what? Whether the loads are transferred to the structural elements or not. What is the load transfer mechanism? So if your structure is there and the slab is there, like at different floor level. So suppose you are going to put the load here, slab. So the slab will transfer the load to the beam, then beam will transfer the load to the column, then column to next column, then to the foundation. The load transfer mechanism. So you have to check whether the loads has been transferred correctly or not. Is there any analysis error or not? So how you can check that? That is also there to discuss in detail. Okay, your analysis is right. Then you should be able to check what is the load transfer. So if you look to the elevation about any view, see. So this is what deformed the shape of structure. So this structure is subjected to only gravitational load. So your deformation should be in vertical direction. If you take your cursor here, so this will show you by what value it is deformed. Okay, then if you want to see the axial force in the columns, so just go to display, go to force stress diagram, go to frame results, and for the factor load combination, I would like to see the axial force in the member, say apply. So axial force will come to the column. So this is what the axial force. So can anyone tell me the axial force from top to bottom will increase or decrease? Hello? Tell me fast.
Increase.
Obviously. So that is the one kind of check also. Too many checks are there. So if you want to check whether you have performed your analysis right or wrong, whether the analysis has been correctly done or not. So see, your force is going to be increased. Let me show you. Go to elevation. So this is what column. So your load is going to be increased. It is 210. Here 518. Here 844. So if you look up from top to bottom, your force is going to be increased. So yeah, is it right? If you want to see the bending moment diagram, go to plan. Go to 3D view. Plan view. I would like to see the bending moment diagram. So bending moment diagram of the beam. So axis 3-3. When to look for the axis 3-3. When to look for the axis 2-2. That's a very, very interesting topic for the discussion. We are covering in detail. So say apply. So this is the bending moment diagram. What does mean by the yellow color? What does mean by the red color? Whether it is a prop, whether is what type of the building is there? Sorry, what type of the beam is there? If the simply supported beam is there, so what should be the bending moment diagram? So bending moment diagram should be like this. If the simply supported beam is there, at the end no movement will be there, zero movement will be there, and at the center maximum movement will be there. So this behavior is for what? For the simply supported beam. If you are having the fixed support beam, so what will be the bending moment diagram? The bending moment diagram will be like this. At the middle maximum movement will be there, and at the ends negative movements will be there, like that. So this is all what, if you are having the basic knowledge about the structural behavior, then you can correct your model. Okay, sometimes what will happen, this is the simply supported beam. This is what, just for example, a simply supported beam, but I am getting the movement at the end. I am getting the movement at the end. So there is something wrong or not? Tell me fast. It is what, actually it is the simply supported beam. Okay, and I am getting the negative movement at their ends. Is it right or wrong? Hello? Anyone tell me fast?
No, wrong.
Is it wrong? So how you can correct this? Software will give you output in respect of your input. Software is not wrong. But you will get the information that you are doing something wrong. So you should have the basic knowledge. That's why I'm asking. So bending moment diagram knowledge you should have for the different kind of structural system. For the different kinds of structural system, and if structural element, you should have how the stresses is going to be developed. Got it? So there is a brief discussion about this also. Okay, I'm not going to take in detail right now. So this is all done. If you want to the shear force diagram, so this is the shear force diagram. If you want to this torsion, so the torsion will be there, like that. So axis consideration is a very important topic. I need to have 1 hour. for the discussion of axis consideration in the software. When to look for the 3-3, when to look for the 2-2, like that. Then last stage is what? We are going to design the structure. We are going to design our structure. So what important things you need to know for the designing of structure? So very important topic is there. Either you want to perform the ductile detailing or not. When to go for the ordinary detailing, when to go for the ductile detailing, which code you have to use. Okay. So what simply you have to do, too many things are there. Okay. Too many things are in respect of the setting of preparing your model for the design. I told you before of every step, some settings will be there. Okay, so that setting we will discuss in detail in our training. But right now, just click on the design section to proceed for the design. So your design is going to be start. And after the completion of the design, it will show you result. So the design output. So this is the design output. After having the design, you should able to check whether is there any member is going to be fail. Is there any member which is failing the design requirement? So that you have to check. Suppose any column is there which is failing. So you should able to check. So what other training centers they do? They are taking simple project like the dummy project, and they will tell you just model the columns and assign the load, and they will show you column is passing is now over. Okay, I am asking to all of you, if you are having some knowledge, just tell me, if suppose one column is going to be failed, so what solutions will be there to make that column to be passed? Tell me fast. Kavita.
Again, you go to the main program and correct that dimension of that column.
Correcting the dimension, okay. Yes, Patil sir. Anyone else? It's a discussion. Tell me. Put your opinion. If one column
or increase the more, increase the concrete grade.
Yes, yes, yes. Okay, anyone else? Yes, Patil sir.
Section change.
Yes.
Sectional properties are may change. Cross section.
Cross section. Yes. That's why I'm asking this question. Everyone will tell you about this. Just increase the section. So it's only the solution to increase the section every time. First,
no.
Find out what is the cause of failure. Patil sir, what is the cause of failure you need to know first? Gupta.
Stiffness is not sufficient.
Yes, yes, I am asking what? You need to find first what is the cause of failure of the column. First, find out that, then go for the solution. If you are going for the treatment, they will check you. What's actually the problem? Then the doctor will suggest the solution. So same thing is there. What others will tell you, just go and increase the section size. I told you, that's not only the solution. Yeah, that's a solution. But that's not only the solution. First, you need to look whether it is going to be fail in flexure, whether it is going to be fail in the shear. What actually the problem? Okay. Where the moment it is going to become long column or short column? In which direction it is lagging in the section depth? It is becoming eccentric column or not? So these all are the reasons. First find out the reason, then go for the solution. So about 3 to 4 session, about 4 to 6 hours we are spending on the discussion about the design of the column in respect of this ETAP software. So very interesting topic to make your design, your column to be passed. So only increasing the section size is not the solution. First find out the reason of the failure. Then go for the treating it. Got it? Then minimum percentage limit, maximum percentage limit, whether it is within the limit or not. So while going to design the structure, 3 to 4 things we have to satisfy. Hello? 3 to 4 things we have to satisfy. Very important point I am going to take. You all are with me? Hello?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. 3 to 4 things we have to know. What? First, we have to satisfy the design requirement. First, we have to satisfy the design requirement. then you have to satisfy the detailed requirement, detailing of the detailing of the section, detailing of the structure. And third, you have to satisfy the site requirement. Hello?
Yes, yes, speak.
You have to satisfy the design requirement. You have to satisfy the codal requirement or detailing requirement, I can say. And third one, you have to satisfy the site requirement. Okay, come to the, it is little bit deep. I need to explain this point. Okay, the design, suppose let's talk about the column. Okay, one column is there, and section size it demands 230 by 600. The design and for design required the section size 230 by 600. Hello, is that okay? So I'm going to provide as per the design requirement 230 by 600. Plus your design requires, suppose 30 number of 16 mm bar. Okay, so I am going to provide 30 number of 16 mm bar. So it is very, very difficult for me to put this reinforcement in this. So 30 number of 16 bar, suppose the percentage of reinforcement is going to become 5%. So our code says that the percentage of limit, okay, not it is 5%, okay, sorry, it is, let's consider 3.5%. 3.5% of the reinforcement is required here to provide in this section. So the code says that the percentage of limit should be 0.8 to 4%. So as per the code, it is right or wrong? Tell me fast.
Right.
It is within the limit. But suppose I am going to provide this percentage of limit in here. So the congestion of the reinforcement is there. Very close reinforcement I need to provide. Other requirement of the code is what? Detailing requirement. So this is the design requirement is okay. If I am providing 3.5% and section size 230 by 600, I am completely correct. I am not wrong. If you are doing this, is that okay? 100%. But what? If you are coming to detailing requirement, so you need to look the detailing requirement also. Detailing requirement. So detailing requirement says that there should be a gap between the two bar should be at least 25 mm. At least 25 mm. But it is the codal requirement. Hello. Okay. If it is closer to, suppose the spacing I am getting 20 mm. I am getting just only the 20 mm. That is lagging with the codal requirement. So design is going to be satisfied. Detailing is going to be satisfied or not?
No.
So you have to satisfy the design also. You have to satisfy the detailing also. Now come to the next point. Suppose I am getting the 25 mm here. I am getting the 25 mm here. Now it's okay. I can provide. Yeah. Tell me. Yeah, okay. But see, what other thing is going to be happen? Experts recommend that there should be at least, this is the codal requirement, okay, there should be at least the gap between these two bar more than 30 or 40 mm. This is the expert recommendation or the site requirement. Am I right or wrong? Hello?
Yeah.
So that if you are providing this much spacing between the, so you can easily place the concrete and slurry, you can put the vibrator also, you can means site execution will be easy. So sitting in the office, you have to take care of the site execution also. You have to make your design such that it should be easy to execute on site. So this is the one point I have taken. Too many points are there. So the design you have to satisfy, detailing you have to satisfy, and the site requirement you have to satisfy. Means code you have to satisfy, design you have to satisfy, and site requirement you have to satisfy. Is that clear or not? Hello?
Yeah.
Is that okay? Kavita?
Yes,
Kavita, I'm audible. Okay, now next, what we are discussing, see what these values are. So too many things are there, just try to understand, okay, to understand the design output. So this is what beam reinforcement at its top, at its bottom. Then how to read these results and see how to read this result, how to check, how to validate your output, how to validate your output in respect of the design code. How to validate your design output in respect of the design code. Okay, suppose let's see, IS456 says that minimum percentage of reinforcement in the beam is should be what? Let me show you. What, can anyone tell me what is the minimum percentage of limit for the beams? Tell me fast.
0.2%.
No, wrong.
0.8.
No, that is for the column. A formula is there in the IS456. Let me find out. That's a difficult actually. But wait for a minute. Sorry, yes. See, this is what? This is the limitation. This much reinforcement you have to provide in the beam. So you have to check whether your software is following this code or not, correctly or not. So if you look, so depth of the beam, what is the depth of beam? Just right click over this. And depth of the beam is what? 230 by 500. And if clear cover is effective cover is what? 45 mm. Clear cover is what? 45 mm, and total depth is what? 500. So 500 minus 45, how much you are getting? Tell me fast. 455, am I right? So effective depth of the beam is what? 455. So just put this formula. Area of reinforcement AST is equal to 0.85 multiplied by 230 into 455 divided by what grade of steel that is we have used for this reinforced for this structure is 500. Now tell me what is the answer. 0.85, 230, 455. Tell me fast. Hello. Point eighty five multiplied by 230 multiplied by 455 just equal to and divided by 500. How much you are getting? Tell me fast. Hello. Why you are not answering? See. Patil sir. It is 177. It is what? 177. And what minimum reinforcement provided by the software? Tell me fast. Is it right or wrong?
178.
Is it right? Hello. So you have to validate the design output also. You have to validate the design output also. So this kind of practice we are doing. This kind of practice we are doing, and after having the design result, we are going to prepare the schedule. And lot of things are there to discuss in respect of the scheduling. In respect of what? Scheduling. So we are going to prepare the schedule for the beams. Manually we are going to discuss where to put the reinforcement, what does mean the bottom reinforcement, what does mean the top reinforcement, how to decide the positions of the reinforcement. That's a very important topic. How you can decide the positions of the reinforcement, when to provide at the bottom, when to provide at the top, when to curtail it, what does mean the curtailment, what does mean the lapping, what is the lap length, development length, what is the formula for calculating the lap length, development length. In respect of the scheduling and detailing, very detailed discussion will be there about 8 to 10 hours. And according to that, we are going to prepare the schedule for the beams, for the different floors. Then there are details we are also discussing, how to prepare the details. Then we are going to see the preparing the schedule of column. Then there are details. Then we are going to prepare the schedule of slab. So we are having the sheets, excellent sheets for the preparing the schedule of for the preparing the schedule of
slab
for the designing of the slab. For the designing of the slab, we are using this Excel sheet. Okay, for the designing of 2S slab, we are having this kind of excellent sheet. Then we are moving for the design of the foundation. Okay, so lot of things are there for the discussion. We are covering all those things. We are trying to cover all those things. Got it? So just coming back to our model. So preparing the schedule for the beam, for the foundation. Okay, so this is all actually included in this. So first we are going to learn manually. Unless and until you are not having the knowledge about the things doing manually. So what is the use of using the software? Software is just a tool for making your work as easy to save your time. Okay, so manually doing all this schedule and detail will take about, if you are at expert level, if you are knowing about this, so that will take about 1 day for the completion of scheduling and detailing. So there is some supporting element and supporting software that will help you to prepare your schedule and detail in a very short period of time. So we are having the RCDC software. We are having the RCDC software that will make your work easy. So within a short period of time, you can prepare the schedule. You just take the output of the ETAP software into the RCDC software, and within a 5 minutes, the work that takes that may take 2 to 3 hours, that will be completed within 5 minutes. How many minutes? Hello.
Yeah. Carry on.
Yes, within 5 minutes, you have to just take the output from the analysis, ETAPS analysis into RCDC, and with the some basic settings, will finally give the result. For the beams also, then detailing is also giving. So again, I'm telling you, you should having the knowledge how to utilize this software. You should have the knowledge how to utilize this software. Now next, column schedule you can prepare, and foundation schedule you can prepare, slab schedule you can prepare, details, scheduling, everything you can get directly from the software, and you can save your time. So that's very well known software and very demanding software in market. So this is what actually the complete package will make you a structural engineer. And last, we are going to look how to prepare the schedule, design sheet. See, finally you will come to this level. So I told you, after completion of this training, you will be able to design any kind of structure on your own. That kind of confidence you will get from here, and I don't know whether you are getting from anywhere or not. So live sessions we are going to provide you. Live expert will be with you for your doubt clarification every day. 1.5 hour session will be there. Got it? So yeah, this is all about this training program. So here basic will be there, intermediate will be there, and advanced will be there. Everything we are going to cover. So now, if you have any doubt and question, you can ask. The training is going, it's a request to all of you, kindly put your name and contact number in the chat box. Kindly put your names and contact number in the chat box, please. And see, the training registration has been started. It is going to be started from 6th of October. So book your seat as much as possible. Okay. The training is going to be start from 6th of October. Daily session will be in evening 7:30 to 9:30 or 9 p.m. Is there any doubt, question? You can ask now. It's your time. Kindly put your name and contact number in the chat box fast. Please don't miss it. And if you have any question, doubt, you can ask. Tell me, what's your doubt? What's your question? After completion of this demo session, you can register your seat.
Hello.
Yes, Sanjay.
Sir, आपका शेड्यूल फरवरी में होगा?
Sorry.
फरवरी में आपका शेड्यूल होगा क्या ट्रेनिंग का?
Yes. It is continue. It will be continue after the completion of one program. It will be continue.
अच्छा जब फरवरी में होगा तो उसकी डिटेल्स उस टाइम पे मतलब हो जाएगी प्रोवाइड हो जाएगी किस टाइम
पे सब चीजें
ओके थैंक यू
इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट एंड क्वेश्चन यू कैन आस्क फास्ट आफ्टर हैविंग दिस ट्रेनिंग यू विल बी एबल टू फेस एनी इंटरव्यू
आर वी एबल टू डिजाइन फॉर द कंटीन्यूअस लैब्स
यस Every kind of slab we will discuss for the designing purpose.
Generally, by default, it takes two-way slab. By default, for particular one slab, if we want to change the direction of that particular
slab. How to design that, we will see. How to design that cantilever slab, irregular geometry. We are trying to cover all the complication. Okay, so that will take.
Sir, in brochure you mentioned that lifetime axis, na. So what
yes,
does that
yes.
mean?
Yes, long life axis will be there. Yes, definitely.
So what does that mean? The recorded videos are opened in life or what is it?
Recorded videos will be long life. Daily live session will be there. Next day of the session, you will get the recorded video and that recorded video will be long life with you, probably.
Okay, it is a Google Drive link or any other thing?
We will provide. Our system is there. Don't worry about that. That's our responsibility. You will get. Don't worry.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Can you cover bungalow type structure?
See, every type of this kind of complicated, as you can see, who will teach this kind of structure? Complicated. Is this complicated?
Yes, got. Complication is clear. But bungalows are common one. That's the reason I know.
See, sir, once you've done it, you will get the idea. I told you, every project will have the unique difficulty. Okay. It is having some changes. But basic things will be same. Martin, sir?
Okay, fine. Okay. And is RCDC is a free one or it's required any...
Sorry?
RCDC structure is a free one?
That we will provide.
Okay. And how registration will be complete?
Sorry?
How to complete registration?
See, you have to pay the enrollment fee. Okay. 4,500. Once you've done the payment to this number 8857891345. See. This number 8857891345. You have to pay the fee to this number, okay, and send me the screenshot to the same number. And once you send the screenshot, we will ask some basic details like your names and mail ID. Your registration will be completed. This is my number 8857891345. What is it, sir?
Can you repeat please number again?
Look into the chat box 8857891345. GPay will be there.
Okay. GPay.
Yes.
Can we complete from Paytm also, na?
Sorry. Yes.
Can we?
Paytm.
Hello.
Yes, Madan sir.
Hello. Two things I want to know. Means ki for the foundation point of view. Means ki this type of foundation you will cover. And second thing, which dynamic method? Second thing, which dynamic method you will use for the analysis of high-rise structure?
Yes. We are going to cover response spectrum method of analysis. Okay. And in respect of the foundation, we are going to deal isolated foundation. There is a sense that so many types of the foundation as you know, like raft foundation, pile foundation and different types of the foundation is there. So there's a different course for the safe software. Okay. Here we are going to cover one complete project. So isolated foundation may be there and combined foundation may be there. So that kind of foundations will be there.
Means raft and combined pile raft are only pile we will not cover.
No.
Okay. Can you please repeat which kind of foundation will cover?
Sorry?
Can you please repeat which kind of foundation will cover?
isolated foundation, combined foundation may be there. What that depends on the type of the project, what project we are going to take, and what kind of demand requirement of the foundation. How I can tell? If the reaction is more, it demands combined foundation, we will go for the combined. If it is rough, means it is going to satisfy with the isolated foundation, that will be okay. The cost fee is 4,500 only. Many of you are asking about the 4,500 only the cost fee. Okay. And no hidden charges will be there. All the things is included here. Nothing. You don't need to pay single rupee beyond of this 4,500.
Sir, one more thing for the foundation, which software are you using?
Foundation, we are going to use RCDC software and advanced Excel sheet is there. Using that, we are going to design the foundation.
Okay, in Excel sheet, we can design the all types of foundations
yes,
is
yes,
available.
Exactly.
Okay, thank you, sir.
What's the other payment method except the Google Pay, because I don't use the Google Pay.
What do you want? Will you comfort with the Paytm?
Paytm is fine.
So, if you have any personal issue, you can contact me. Don't worry. If you have any personal issue, you can contact me. 885789, just after the demo, you can contact me. This is my 885789-1345. WhatsApp me, contact me. By any way, we will find the solution. Don't worry.
Okay.
Hello. And just write your name and contact number in the chat box, please. Yes, Madan sir.
One more thing. After designing, means detailing will be more important. Okay. So yes. In detailing part, you will means cover these things. Means how we provide the legend and text, and how we prepare the seats, or simply means what type of discussion you will.
Yes, sir. Yes, definitely. Very, very detailed discussion will be there in respect of your scheduling and detailing. Very detailed discussion will be there. Okay. In respect of your codal requirement, SP34, we are going to strictly follow SP34.
So one request from my side. Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible, sir. Can you speak loudly, sir, please?
Can you take any project in which means the raft or file is included, if possible?
Sorry, sir.
Means can you take any project, means the real life project in which raft or means the file foundation is means given?
Yes. Actually, we are using the safe software for that, sir. Okay, so if you are interested in foundation, we will let you know if you have the special course for the foundation will be there. Okay, sir. Actually,
hello.
Many things we are... Yes, Patil, sir.
Sir, not in detail. Just please explain how to import ETAP file into RCDC. Just basic explanation.
Okay. So actually, see, simple analysis, RCDC software is what? Is a 2D software and it is able of designing the structure, scheduling the structure, detailing the structure and to a certain extent, preparing the BBS and costing of the structure. Okay, Ravindra Singh, sir. First thing. Second
yes,
thing is what? It requires analysis report. It demands the analysis report. Okay, so you can't perform the analysis in the RCDC software. So you have to give the analysis report, analysis result to the RCDC software. Then RCDC will able to do all its responsibility like designing, scheduling, detailing and all. So different software like attachment is there with this ETAP software, with the STAT Pro software. So you have to first analyze the structure in the ETAP software. Once you complete the analysis, you have to export the analysis result from these ETABs, and that analysis report you have to import in the RCDC software. Got it, sir?
Okay, sir, but I think it's not too easy to import RCDC, no?
No, it's simple. But you need to understand it. You need to understand it. Okay, it's simple. Not much complication is there. But again, I will explain all these things in a way that you will feel it is easy. Okay. Yes. Anyone? Fast, tell me. We have more 5 to 10 minutes. If you have any doubt and question, otherwise we are going to conclude it. How was the demo? Tell me fast.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, is the recorded will be available of this lecture?
Yes, yes, it will be available on our channel. Our channel link is there in the chat box. See.
Yes.
In the chat box, our channel link Stuxoft Center is there. Okay. So you can visit this channel, and lot of things are there over the channel. But the things that we have included in this training, that will not be available on YouTube anywhere. Okay. So it will be very beneficial for you if you want to start your career as a structural engineer, and if you are working professional as a site engineer in academics, if you are having. So if you want to change your work profile from site or for academics to the design field, so this is a good chance and good place for you. Yes, sir, we will discuss all this type of the design of foundation in our project. Shall we conclude now?